Hi, this is Jan from Let's Build Shopify, and today's video is all about Shopify's theme templating language that is called Liquid. And the goal is that by the end of this video, you will have a very good understanding of what is going on in your theme files. And if you've seen my last videos on HTML and CSS, you might even be able to start building your own theme templates, and you will also be able to make some customizations that you just couldn't implement using HTML and CSS only. So this should be a lot of fun, and let's go. All right, so by now you may ask yourself already what Liquid actually is, or even more important, where it comes into play and what it is used for. So let's start by answering these questions together. So let's imagine one day you're pulling out your smartphone and maybe you decide to visit one of my epic product pages, maybe the one for the clay plant pot that I've shown in one of my videos. And your request would then go to a Shopify server, which is basically nothing more than a giant powerful computer somewhere on the internet. So you could imagine your smartphone saying something like, "Hey server, could you please send me this product page?" And the server would say, "Yeah man, no problem, but let me quickly look that up." And now the server gets a little bit nervous because he knows he has to be fast, and he's thinking something like, "Oh man, I need to deliver this product page for the clay plant pot." So hysterically, he starts searching within the theme files until he finds something like the product template liquid. And this file seems to contain some HTML, maybe some CSS and JavaScript that would make up a product page. So maybe he could just send this file to your smartphone. But there's one problem with that file. And the problem arises because back when the theme was created, the developer didn't want to make a new product page for every single product, but instead he wanted to create one product template file that would work with any product. So if you would have a look inside one of these files, you would find some HTML. Here we have a heading level 1 with a CSS class of product single title, but you would also find a lot of placeholder values. For instance, here we have double curly brackets followed by product.title, and down below we have the product.description enclosed in double curly brackets, and even further down we have a single curly bracket followed by a percentage sign. So this is a little bit different, and here it says something like, for every variant in the product variants, we want to output a new option value to the product page, and we also want to display the variant title. And if the variant is not available, we want to add a small text that it's sold out. So this is Liquid right in action. And it also explains why it's called a template language, because this would serve as a template for any product. Okay, so now the server that is still in a rush is taking a look at all the data that you've defined in the Shopify backend. And in fractions of a second, all the data gets filled in. And now you could see that the product.title was replaced with clay plant pot, and the description was added, and all the options were rendered. And now we no longer see any Liquid code, because after the evaluation, we are only left with the results. All right, so back in the big picture, after all this evaluation on the server side has been done, the server now feels pretty confident to send out the results. And again, they would only contain HTML, CSS, and maybe some JavaScript, but no longer Liquid code. And once your browser gets all the data, you would know how to display the page, and you could finally buy one of my plant pots. All right, I really hope you like these animated kind of explanations, because they really took me more effort than they may look like. And before we move on to a practical example in Shopify, let me quickly explain what these double curly brackets mean in contrast to these curly bracket followed by a percentage sign. And as a rule of thumb, you could say that these double curly brackets more often appear when there's raw data output, for example, the product.title or the product.price, the product description, and so on. And these curly brackets followed by a percentage sign are used when there's logic involved. So maybe you could do something like, if the cart total price is greater than 50, then do something, or you could iterate over products in a collection. Basically anything that is involved with logic. All right, as promised in the beginning, let's get into building our own theme templates. And I was thinking of a good example that's not too difficult, and I came up with this one. So let's imagine you have this Deals of the Week page where you would offer exclusive deals for your loyal and locked in customers, and they would change over the week. And maybe we could have a look at the site, and I have the debut theme installed and not too crazy customized. And on this page, one would read about any topic. For now, we could stick to this clay pot example because we used it all through the video. So maybe one would write about the 5 best indoor plans for apartments with low maintenance. And later, this could be recycled into a blog article to help with the search engine ranking. But for the deal of the week, it's membership exclusive content. And then down here, we have a discount code for 15% off on all clay plant pots. And we have the product link down here. And you could even customize the product. This is from another video. But let's work on making this membership exclusive content. All right, so the first step is to create a new page template. And therefore I go to my theme files. I can simply click this little action button and then edit code, because this would bring up the Shopify theme file editor. And once this loads, you have this template folder, and here we have page.liquid. This is the default template, and we could create a new template right here. And this will be for a page. Maybe we could just call it deals. And then I click on create template, and you would see that this just duplicates the default template. Okay, now I can go back to the deal of the week page, and in the right half, you would see the template, and now I can select the page.deals template. So let's save it. And now we would need to make all our modifications straight to this page.deals.liquid file, and we no longer need this page.liquid default template, so we can just close it out. Okay, so let's try to understand what is going on in this template. So let me zoom in a little bit so you can read this better. And it's not too complicated, so we can get a good overview. We have some HTML containers and they have some CSS classes to them. And down here we have a heading level 1 that contains the page title. So here we have some data output with Liquid. And down below we have the page content that is also put out through Liquid. And now I will go ahead and add some spacing so we can read this better. So here we have the page title with its container, and here we have the page content with its container. And to turn this into membership exclusive content, we could now perform a check on top of this content. So I will type curly brace and then percentage sign, because now I will implement some logic. And I will write if customer, which is equivalent of saying if the user or the visitor is a logged in customer, then I want to do something. And whenever you start an if statement, you need to terminate it as well. So end if at the bottom. So if the user is a logged in customer, I want to output all the page content. And otherwise, so we could type else, I want to notify, or I want to explain that this is membership exclusive content, and I will give him the opportunity to log in into an account. So let's copy the content from above so that we can have the same HTML container. But instead of the page content, we will now output maybe a heading level 2. And this should say membership exclusive content. Maybe a break line or two. And then an A tag, which is a HTML link. And then we could say something like, please log in here. And the href, so the link should point to /account/login. And now we could already try to save this, but I feel we could also improve this a little bit. And instead of the page title, if the user is a logged in customer, we could output something like maybe the customer first name, customer.first_name. And now we should save this and give it a try. And after a quick refresh on the front end, I'm no longer able to see the exclusive content because I'm not logged in right now. So let me go ahead and do this. And after logging in into my account, I can now see the exclusive content. And on top it says my first name, Jan. I should have put something like, hello Jan, but it doesn't matter, you get the idea. And this is working fine, cool. If you want to learn more about Shopify's theme templating language, I highly recommend checking out the Liquid cheat sheet, because this gives a good overview on all the different objects that you would have access to using Liquid. And you could also follow along with this guide or walk that through. It is written by Shopify, and I will link both in the video description. And last but not least, I want to thank you for watching. I really hope you found some value in this video and you learned something new. And if you have questions, you could always leave them down in the comment section. And if you haven't already, you can subscribe to the channel so you don't miss out on future content. And then I hope to see you in the next video. Bye.